And in lane three, Kovac. Good discipline at the start. And Calvin Smith gets away, and he's really flying, but on his left, it's Ratine. And now Calvin breaks away in the middle, though. It's away from Ratine. Mardy and Kovac were the other two, and Ratine will have to wait. And I may have done Mardy an injustice. I said he ran 10.32, and he looked pretty impressive in lane four.
They're also fighting for lanes in this event. The lanes for the final are certainly, those four lanes in the middle are vitally important.
In the World Junior Championships, Raymond Stewart in lane two. So from one, there's Andonikin from Nigeria. Fourth in the World Juniors and fourth in the African track and field. He's done a great job to get to the semi-finals. Raymond Stewart, Jamaica, finalist in Los Angeles, bronze medalist last year. He's run 9.99 this year. There's a former world record holder, Calvin Smith. First run as an individual in the Olympic Games. One of the big shots here. Desai Williams of Canada. He's been around for so long. Semi-finalist in Los Angeles, but has never been running better. There's the king, Carl, defending champion. No man has won the Olympic Games 100 metres 4 years apart. Lane six, Miles Mills of Ghana, who was the winner of the African Track and Field Championship this year. Mardy of Indonesia, fourth in the Asian Track and Field Championships in 1987. And the Brazilian, Arnaldo Silva. Raylene, the action should be from 2 to 5, Stewart, Smith, Williams and Lewis.
That's right. I'd say Lewis and Smith are going to have a really tough race. Desai Williams and Smith both tend to wind up towards the end of the race. In fact, decelerate slower, as they've been saying on television.
Speed is as fast as Lewis's. Do you think if they're together at 50, Smith can cause an upset here?
I wouldn't be surprised if he tries to pin one on Lewis at this stage, because it must give him a psychological lift some hours before the final. As for Lewis, I don't think it'd harm him too much. I don't think much does.
So Lewis goes from 5. An hour and a half to the final. And this is where he'll really want to establish himself, like he did yesterday in the second round, where he ran 9.99. The winds have been swirling a bit in the stadium, but generally they've been tailwinds. And we saw Florence Griffith away. Lewis slows down. Williams beat him out easily. Stewart away well. Smith's got some work to do. Here comes Carl now. He gathers them in. Lewis goes through. Smith goes through. And so does Mitchell. He's run 9.97. But Smith took forever to wind up. But Williams got the fly. And Lewis took a while to get him.
Desai Williams has got a beautiful acceleration through to 40 metres. You can see Carl Lewis is working very, very hard to get him. He doesn't want to lose this race. He wants to go through unbeaten. Carl Smith at this stage is working very hard. Head back, and he's pulled through for second place. But Carl Lewis, in beautiful form, running with perfect poise.
And Raymond Stewart's third, and there's a thought that he may have injured himself. And fourth, Desai Williams. This is the fastest anyone has run at the Olympic Games at sea level. Only Jim Hines in 1968, with a rarefied atmosphere of Mexico City, was able to run faster than this.